Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and I hope you enjoy this lavender eyeshadow look I created today using this Simple Beauty pigment in the shade 3B. Yeah, I've been playing with a bunch of stuff from Otto's and my box swap. Details down below, so you can check those out. But yeah, I'm going to first start off with the Glam Light Icing Eyeshadow Base. Is a very nice canceling out shade base. And then I'm going in with the star of the show, Simple Beauty Pigment, in the shade 3B. And I'm going to just dot that eyeshadow base on my eyelid and kind of pat it out with my fingers. And then I'm packing on that Simple Beauty pigment in the shade 3B basically all over my eyelid. I wanted that to be the showcase eyeshadow, if you will. But I don't know. I don't know what else I could have done to make it where it wouldn't come off. If you have any ideas, let me know. But I didn't even set my eyeshadow, and I just kept packing and packing, going back and forth in layers and layers, trying to get this color to be very vibrant and stay put. But I did have trouble with this. You'll kind of see it at the end that the pigment kind of disappeared on the eyelid part, or creased in. I guess I could have set it and it might have done better, but I wanted that pigment to be really strong. So I thought if I just pack on more eyeshadow, it would work, but whatever. It's pretty at the end. I did, after I filmed the outro, actually looked in the mirror closer and saw that it was creasing and it was a little bit, not as pigment on the lid. So I did pack on some more eyeshadow at the very end after the video was done, but nevertheless, it's pretty. And then I wanted to use this ABH Nevada palette, and I'm using this color right here. Let me see what this shade is called. Oh, it's B1 out of the palette. It's like a deeper pinky purple color. I wanted to just darken up the outer edges so the color would pop even more. And I'm using this brush to just pack on the eyeshadow and also kind of blend it out. I'm just taking my time going back and forth with this. Now I'm going in with, you can tell I did my face makeup off camera, and I will list the products in my description box below. But yeah, I just used a clean little fluffy brush just to make sure it looks really nice and blended and seamless. And the mascara I'm using today is the Koki Stay Dry Waterproof Mascara. You've heard me complain about that Mecca mascara because it's not waterproof. So I just like waterproof mascaras a whole lot more. Not to say that's a bad one, because I do enjoy it. I just you know, didn't want to fight with it today. I didn't want to have to remember to set my face before mascara. So, and I wanted to put more love into this Koki one that I've had in my collection before it dries up or, you know, expires. It might be expired already, but it worked really good. So I was happy with it. And now I'm going to go in with my Makeup Mecca eyelash glue. And I've really been really enjoying this. And then I'm also, the lashes are the Kiss So Wispy lashes. I really love these lashes. As you can tell, pretty major difference between the lashes and no lashes. And you'll see me applying this. It was a little difficult because I probably put too much on it, to be honest. I think less works better. Okay, now I'm using the Kiss little eyelash tweezer thingies to pinch my real lashes with my fake. That way it's just a little bit more seamless and blended in. Yeah, because I didn't want a big thick eyeliner and I didn't want to mess with other eyeshadows. So, but yeah, this is the end of this look. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know if you've tried any of the Simple Beauty pigments. And if you have, let me know in the comments. Are any of these products in what you think? Or if you have any recommendations or anything you can think of that you want to ask me in the comments. I really like this look, but definitely could have turned out better. I personally think the Jeffree Star, I think it's the Jawbreaker palette, has like a lavender color in it. Probably would have worked better because that's a pressed pigment, but I'm enjoying playing with all these pigments. This one just didn't work out the best, but they do have some very lovely shades and I'm enjoying playing with them. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time, buddies. Bye!